So hello everyone, good morning. It's a Sunday and I'm gonna be doing an oil change today on my Harley Sportster, and I thought I'll just take you through it. So if you have a Sportster, you want to do an oil change yourself, you can do it yourself. It's a pretty simple process. You don't need to take it to a shop for that. You know, you just buy your own choice of oil and a filter. You need some very basic tools and you can do it yourself. You can save yourself some money because wherever you take it, they're typically going to charge you quite a bit, you know, on the labor and the service charges, in addition to the oil and the filter. So I'm out for a ride, a short ride, just to warm up my engine, because when you drain the oil, it really helps if you have it hot, because hot oil flows easier, so you can drain out more of it, you know, so that really helps. So I have just about crossed 5,000 kilometers, or around 3,000 miles since my last change. And I try to do it around that point, although Harley recommends 5,000 miles, which is around 8,000 kilometers. The reason being, I ride in hot conditions, dusty conditions, and often through some really bad traffic, as you would have seen from my earlier videos. So I don't really stretch it to the maximum permissible limit, you know. And they do say if you're riding in hot conditions or dusty conditions, you should change it earlier. So I use synthetic oil. You could use mineral oils as well. And the reason I use synthetic is because I ride in hot conditions, dusty conditions, like I said. And quite often I get stuck in really bad traffic, you know, where I have to crawl at like walking speeds, so I can't shut down my engine because I'm crawling, and it doesn't get any cooling because there isn't enough airflow at those low speeds. So it gets really, really hot. And the thing with mineral oils is, once they've been to such high temperatures a few times, they really degrade pretty fast. So, you know, you go through such traffic regularly, in just a month or so, your oil would be no good anymore. Right, so that's one of the reasons I... Oh, dog is kind of like dazed or something. So yeah, that's the reason I use synthetic oils. Yeah, like I said, I changed them around 5,000 kilometers or 3,000 miles. If I don't do that quick enough, I change them around a year or so anyway. Right, so just to be safe. So the Sportsters, they don't have a traditional, you know, drain plug underneath the engine. They have this hose, I don't know if you can see it, there's a hose here and this plastic plug, and that's held by this the hose clamp. So you just need to undo this hose clamp and pull out this plug. That'll cause the oil to drain. So it's a lot easier than having a drain plug underneath the engine. So just unscrew the hose clamp. Just be careful, the engine is still hot. Yeah, the clamp is loose now, as you can see here. So just get the drain pan and gently pull out the plug. Be careful again, the oil is hot. It's not going to be scalding hot, but anyway, There you go. So of course it's not going to be flowing very freely yet because I have to open up the tank filling cap. That's going to let the air in. And that'll take about half an hour to drain. Well, as you can see now, it's almost drained out, but it's still draining. So I'd wait for all of it to drain out, which, yeah, it does take quite some time. And towards the end, I would also recommend straightening up the bike, getting it off the side stand, and draining out any remaining oil from the tank. Okay, so this is pretty much done. And now we have to undo the oil filter. And this filter does not have a nut here, so... Well, typically they say you can undo it by hand, but I know from experience that it's not easy. So I have an oil filter removal wrench, which I'll show you. And this is it. Turns. Gotta get the drain pan ready. See, it's still not loose enough to turn by hand. And there'll be quite a lot of oil draining from that opening, and it does make your motor mount dirty there, but can't be helped. So I'll probably just gonna be leaving it like that over there now. The next time I wash my bike, I'll be taking care of that. Okay, is it time to put in the new filter? I have a Canon oil filter here. And this one has the nut that you can use to tighten it up or loosen it up. Although, typically, for tightening, you should only use, you should only do it by hand. So I'm just making sure this is where the gasket from the filter will seal. So we just have to make sure this is clean. There's no dirt or debris here that can cause problems with the sealing. Do the same thing with the gasket. It's clean. Now, this is optional. Some people do it, some don't. I'm going to be filling the filter up about halfway with fresh oil. Now, that aids with the circulation of the oil when you fill in the fresh oil and start the engine up for the first time. I've got Motul 2050, which is what that's the viscosity needed by Harleys, most Harleys, I think. So I'm gonna take some fresh oil, put it on the gasket. And that should help with the sealing. And now I'll fill it up halfway with the fresh oil. You can't really see inside, so you have to kind of guess how far halfway is. And I'm gonna put it back in. Don't fill it too much, because when you put it in sideways, it's gonna drain out. Okay, they say spin it till the point where the gasket makes contact with the engine, and another half to three-fourths of a turn. So let me see if I can do it by hand. It's like a quarter. Nah, need a spanner. We did one quarter, so now the half a turn should do it. Okay. Doesn't need to be tightened anymore, or it could damage the gasket. Alright, so the filter is done. I'm gonna put in the plug for the drain pipe. Okay, so time to put the plug in. It's still draining drop by drop, but it's okay. And if you really want, it could wait a little longer and drain all of it, but it's okay. Ah, jeez, I need to put in the clamp first. You can't see, I'm sure, but you get the idea how it's done. Best if you've got a headlight, you know, the lights which you put on your head with a strap, that would really help in this condition. But I'm using my helmet camera, so can't really use that right now. And that's about done. Yeah. Okay, so the plug is in. Now, the oil capacity is about 4 quarts, or about 4 liters. But this is a dry sump, so there'll always be some oil. There'll always be some oil left in the engine and the other parts through which it circulates. So usually it takes about 3 quarts or 3 liters from my experience. So now it's all empty. And some of this has been used in the filter. So I'm left with most of it. Very little that went in the filter. That's the first one. Here goes the second liter. Let's open up the third one, and actually that may be enough. We may not need to open up the fourth one now. Usually once you've ridden for a day or so, it may go down a bit, then we need to top it up a little more. So put in 2 quarts or 2 liters, actually a little more than 2 quarts, it's about 2.1. And you can see the oil from here, but it's better to check the level. So you need to screw it in, and screw it. Ah, there you go. It's around here. So at this point what I should be doing is start the engine. And just do a mental check of everything. Drain plugs plugged in, oil's filled, filters filled and tightened. Turn it on. Now as soon as the engine fires, the low oil pressure lamp should go off in a few seconds at the most. If it does not, you need to shut down the engine immediately. That's a cat. Okay. Now, went off. So we have sufficient oil pressure. Now let the engine run for a minute or so for the oil to circulate. So that's how you'll know if you need more oil in the tank. Because it's a dry sump system, so the oil does not reside in the engine. It resides in the tank and it has to circulate around the engine. Okay, I'll shut it down now. Let the oil settle for a few seconds at least, and then I'm going to check the oil level again. See, it has reduced a bit now, so I'm going to add a little more, but I'm not going to fill it up, okay? So the difference between the lowest and the highest points, that's about 1 quart or about a liter. So I'm going to fill it till here because the oil is still not heated up. You know, when the oil is hot, it expands. So what I'm thinking is if I fill it up to about little less than halfway, when the oil is hot, it's going to reach up to, you know, close to the top end. So So, I'm going to put in a little less than half of this. That should be good. So we're at here. I fill little more than what I had intended to, but this should be okay. So now, even when the engine is hot, I should not need to top it up again. So this level with cold oil, it's good. Right, that's it. The oil change is done. So that's it guys, that's the oil change on a Harley Sportster. I hope you found it useful. If you try doing it yourself, I hope you find this video useful. And if you have any questions, any suggestions, any clarifications you need, just let me know. I'll try to help you out best I can. Sorry then. Until next time, bye guys.